to a job.
As a ninja?
No. No, I'm going to a funeral as a professional mourner. Thank you very much.
That's a thing?
Yeah. You know, they hire people to be sad and fill out a room. That way it's less sad that there aren't enough people to fill out a room.
I was basically posting on Vine. It was a 6-second video app that died. Rest in peace. I do miss it. But yeah, I was basically fired from that app and had to transition into YouTube. But it was amazing. That's how I got my start. I was in high school. I was, I think, 17, turning 18 when I posted my first like little video on the internet. And it kind of just took off from there, which is so weird that 6 seconds has brought me to a 22-minute, 8-episode series. It blows my mind.
No, I mean your crying skill. What sets you apart? I'm what's known as a pretty crier. She can fill her eyes with tears, and they never fall. And she is a wailer.
So in the very first episode, basically Liza on Demand speaks of the story of a girl who is in the gig economy. If you don't know what the gig economy is, look at your phone. That's where you can find it. It's literally every app that you have where you hire a personal assistant. Our phones have made us the most bougie generation possible. We hire people to go and drive us around on Uber or go and pick up our food on Postmates. So all of these different apps, you know, we're basically living our life through our phone now. And that's kind of the story that you follow on Liza on Demand. It's about a girl named Liza, which is pretty cute, kind of cool. And she basically has created a career for herself on her phone. She goes out and she goes on these different missions to basically do tasks for other people, whether that be their laundry or whether that be driving them around or whether that be babysitting a plant, specifically an orchid, or being a professional mourner. So all of these different tasks Liza has to do,